Shri Gurubhyo Namaha students, I have discussed how to find A inverse in 3x3 matrix. First, what A inverse? What is the formula? I said A inverse equal to 1 by determinant A into Aj A. 1 by determinant A into Aj A. First, I am going to find determinant A. Determinant, let A equal to the given matrix you are represented as A. So A equal to 1 0 0 0 cos alpha sin alpha 0 sin alpha minus cos alpha. Determinant A we need, so first you are going to find out what is determinant A. Determinant means the bracket should be removed and you have to draw two vertical lines, 1 0 0 0 cos alpha sin alpha 0 sin alpha minus cos alpha. So first entry 1, if you are selecting this, you have to delete that row and delete the column. You arrive 2 by 2 determinant. So 1 into 2 by 2 determinant, 1 into cos alpha sin alpha sin alpha minus cos alpha. Next, first entry is positive, next is negative, so minus 0 into, suppose if you have minus here, minus into minus plus, but here 0, so no problem. You have to delete that row, first row, second column, the remaining 0 sin alpha 0 minus cos alpha 0 sin alpha 0 minus cos alpha plus, positive, negative, positive. Now if you are selecting this in element, you have to delete that first row and third column, so the rest of the thing is 0 cos alpha 0 sin alpha. Now 1 into determinant, find the value of the determinant in 2 by 2, you know, product of main diagonal minus product of sub diagonal. So minus cos alpha into cos alpha, cos square alpha minus sin alpha into sin alpha, sin square alpha minus 0 into whatever it is, 0 plus 0. Now you see, minus you should take it as a common, you arrived as cos square alpha plus sin square alpha. You know the trigonometry identity, cos square alpha plus sin square alpha equal to 1. So your determinant value is minus 1. Your determinant value is minus 1. Cos square alpha plus sin square alpha equal to 1. Next, we want to find adjoint of A. Before find adjoint of A, we need cofactor. For that purpose, first I told you the middle element you have to select, cos alpha, that you should do it in the right side of the margin, cos alpha, then below cos alpha sin alpha, above cos alpha the element is 0, then the same thing you should repeat. Next, move towards right, sin alpha, below sin alpha you have minus cos alpha, above sin alpha 0, the same you have to end with that sin alpha, then move towards left, that is 0, below 0 again 0, above 0 1, the same. Now first column what you wrote, the same thing you repeat at the end. Sin alpha 0 cos alpha. Now cofactor of A is equal to minus cos square alpha minus sin square alpha. Next, sin alpha into 0, 0 minus cos alpha into 0, 0. So directly you write it as 0 as the second element. The same way, 0 into sin alpha 0, 0 into cos alpha 0. Sin alpha into 0, 0, 0 into minus cos alpha 0. Next, minus cos alpha minus 0 into 0, 0. So you directly write minus cos alpha. Here 0 into 0, 0 minus sin alpha. 0 minus sin alpha, you can write it as sin alpha. The same way, 0 into sin alpha 0 minus 0 into cos alpha 0. So you write only the element as 0. 0 into 0, 0 minus sin alpha. Next, 1 into cos alpha minus 0. So you write it as cos alpha. This is cofactor of A. Adjoint of A is equal to transpose of cofactor. Cofactor, I told you already, it is denoted by capital AIJ. Here we found as cofactor, that we are going to write it as a transpose. Here, which is equal to, simplify that, minus 1, 0, 0, 0 minus cos alpha. Sorry, shall I write it at the next step? Which is equal to minus 1, 0, 0, 0 minus cos alpha minus sin alpha, 0 minus sin alpha cos alpha. You simplify and then find out what is adjoint. Adjoint of A, I told you, transpose of cofactor of the matrix. Cofactor you found. Now we are going to write it as a transpose. Transpose is nothing but row become a column. So adjoint of A equal to minus 1, 0, 0. The second row, you are going to write it as a column. 0 minus cos alpha minus sin alpha. Next, the third row, you are going to write it as a third column. 0 minus sin alpha cos alpha. Over, we found what is determinant A and what is adjoint of A. Here one thing I want to give, you should make it as a note. Determinant A is not equal to 0, means A inverse exists. Determinant A not equal to 0. Here we arrive, determinant A is not equal to minus 1. So it is not equal to 0. It is not equal to 0, that means A inverse exists. If determinant A equal to 0 means A inverse does not exist. Determinant A not equal to 0 means A inverse exists. If it is equal to 0, A inverse does not exist. So A inverse equal to 1 by determinant A, we found that, minus 1. Adjoint of A, we arrived the result as minus 1, 0, 0, 0 minus cos alpha minus sin alpha 0 minus sin alpha cos alpha. Here minus 1 is there. Use that and divide the entries. So if you divide the entries, if both are negative, you arrive as positive. So 1 by minus 1 into 0, you arrive as 0. The same here also 0. Here 1 by minus 1 into 0, 0. Here minus cos alpha divided by minus 1. So minus minus positive, you arrived as cos alpha. Minus sin alpha divided by minus 1, you arrived as sin alpha. Minus 1, 1 by minus 1, you can take it as minus 1 into 0, 0. Minus 1 into sin alpha, minus sin alpha, sin alpha. Here it becomes minus cos alpha. A inverse equal to, using minus 1, you can shift minus 1 to the numerator. So 1 by 1, you know minus 1, use that and multiply the entries what it exists inside the bracket. A in final answer, A inverse equal to 1, 0, 0, 0 cos alpha, sin alpha, 0 sin alpha, minus cos alpha. Sometimes you arrived A inverse as a given matrix, not always. Here let A equal to 3, 7, 2, 5 and B equal to 6, 8, 7, 9. Matrix is given. We are going to verify AB the whole inverse equal to B inverse A inverse. This is a result we had, a proof is there. So first we should find out what is AB. AB is nothing but A into B. AB equal to 3, 7, 2, 5 into B. 6, 8, 7, 9. Multiplication, you have to listen carefully. First row, first column. 3, 6 are 18 plus 7, 7 are 49. First row, first column. Want to sum. Next. First row, second column. 3, 8 are 24 plus 7, 9 are 63. Next, second row, second column. 6, 2 are 12 plus 5, 7 are 35. Second row, second column. 2, 8 are 16 plus 5, 9 are 45, which is equal to 18 plus 49, 7, remaining 1, 5, 1, 4 plus 1, 5, 5 plus 1, 6. Next, 63 plus 24, 4 plus 3, 7. Here you arrived, 6 plus 2, 8. 12 plus 35, 5 plus 2, 7, 3 plus 1, 4. So, 47. Next, 16 plus 45, 6 plus 5, 11, remaining 1, 4 plus 1, 5, 5 plus 1, 6. Now, next we need A, next AB the whole inverse equal to formula. 1 by determinant AB. Here AB is there, so instead of A, you are going to write AB. 1 by determinant AB into HAB. Into HAB. The same formula, A inverse equal to 1 by determinant A into HA. Here two letters are there, that is AB. So instead of A, you wrote AB. Here also the same. Next, determinant AB. Determinant AB equal to determinant 67, 87, 47, 61. See, better do the calculation in the right side. 67, 61. Product of main diagonal. 7, 6, 6 sevens are 42. Remaining 4, 36 plus 4, 40. So 7, 8, 0, 4. Product of main diagonal is 4, 0, 8, 7 minus 87 into 47. Do the calculation in the right side. 7 sevens are 49. Remaining 4, 56, 60. 4 sevens are 28. Remaining 2, 32, 34. 9, 8, 0, 4. 4089. 4087 minus 4089. So you arrived minus 2. Already I discussed. Determinant A is not equal to 0 means you can conclude that inverse exists. Here also it is not equal to 0. Therefore, AB, the whole inverse exists. Next step, adjoint of AB. It is easy in the 2 by 2 matrix. Just you should change the main diagonal entries and change the sub-diagonal entry. Change the sign of sub-diagonal, sorry. Change the main diagonal entry. What is the main diagonal here? 67, 61. So you are going to change 61 in the place of A11. 67, you are going to fill it in A22. Next, change the sign of sub-diagonal. That is minus 87 minus 47. Right? Adjoint of AB. Now, AB, the whole inverse equal to 1 by determinant AB. Determinant AB is minus 2. The minus, if you want, you write it at the numerator. Minus 1 by 2, 61, minus 87, minus 47, 67. You should use that and multiply. Minus 1 by 2 into 61. Minus 61 by 2. Minus into minus plus. So 87 by 2. Here. Minus into minus plus 47 by 2. Minus 1 by 2 into 67. Minus 67 by 2. Equation number 1, because we are going to verify. Next, we need B inverse and A inverse. First, B inverse. B inverse. For that, B inverse equal to the same formula A inverse we had general. 1 by determinant B into Aj B. 1 by determinant B into Aj B. First, you should find out what is determinant B. Determinant B equal to 6, 8, 7, 9 equal to 6 nines or 54 minus 8 sevens or 56, which is equal to minus 2. Determinant B equal to minus 2. Here also the same condition, it is not equal to 0. Therefore, you conclude that inverse exists. When you can conclude the determinant not equal to 0, only you can conclude inverse exists. Now, B inverse equal to 1 by determinant B, that is minus 2, the same minus you shift to the numerator, and then Aj B. Aj B, it is 2 by 2 matrix, so it is easy for you to interchange the main diagonal entries, that is 6, 9, 6. Next, change the symbol of subdiagonal. -8, -7. The same. -9/2. +8/2. You don't want to simplify. Let it be as such. -7/2. -6/2. Over. Next, A inverse. To find A inverse, A inverse equal to 1/determinant A into adj A. Determinant A you are going to find out. Determinant A equal to 3, 7, 2, 5. Main diagonal 15. Minus sub diagonal, so 7 to 14 equal to 1. Here also the same, not equal to 0. Therefore, A inverse exists. Now, A inverse equal to 1/determinant A. Determinant A is 1, so 1/1. Adjoint of A. Adjoint of A, you are going to change the main diagonal entry, change the sign of subdiagonal. So, what is your A there? 3, 5. So, 5 will come to A11, 3 will move to A22, then 7, positive 7 will act as -7, positive 2 will act as -2, which is equal to 5, -7, -2, 3. A inverse equal to. The next step we are going to find out what is B inverse A inverse. Multiplication you are going to do. What is your B inverse? Minus. Now, if you have a confusion, better you should have 1/2 outside. The numerator alone you should fill it in the bracket. -9, 8, -7, -6. Then A inverse 5, -7, -2, 3. Let's say 1/2 you keep as such. This bracket alone you have to multiply. 1/2 into first row, first column. -9 into 5, -45. 8 into -2, -16. Next, first row, second column. -into -, +9. 7 saw 63 plus 8 3 saw 24. Next, 7, second row, first column. 7 5 saw 35. -into -+, 6 2 saw 12. Next, second row, second column. 7 7 saw 49. Minus is there, so -49. -6 into 3, -18, which is equal to, the 1/2 is common, you don't forget to write 1/2. -45, -16, -61. 63 plus 24, 87. 35 plus 12, 47. -49, -18, -67. Then you use 1/2 and multiply. B inverse into A inverse equal to -61/2, 87/2, 47/2, -67/2. Equation number 2. See, verify your first equation and the second equation. First entry, I arrived 61 by 2. Here also the same minus 61 by 2. Second entry, 87 by 2. Here also I got it as 87 by 2. 47 by 2, 47 by 2. Minus 67 by 2, 67 by 2. So, that equation 1 is represented your LHS. Equation 2 is represented your RHS. So, LHS equal to RHS. LHS equal to RHS. Or you can write it at the top. Equation 1 is equal to equation 2. Hence, verify. Here I commit one mistake. You should not do that. You should be careful and complete the thing correctly.